My name is Brother JD, and I got myself a dream. This is my story.
What's up, everybody? It's your brother JD right here. El Rey's Garage, just like the old days, like on YouTube. Anyway, what we're doing, I'm gonna give you a quick rundown. This is a 51 Chevy businessman's coupe. This is a business coupe, 51 Chevrolet.
I'd say it all started when I picked up a crusty 1951 Chevrolet Deluxe.
I pulled the old plugs out of it. Looks like the plugs are new. I cleaned them up on the wire wheel.
I brought that old bomb back to life. Had it running good and had big plans for it. That is, until my wife got involved. See, as my little woman helped me bring that old bucket back from the brink of death, she became attached to it. She also started to have her own visions of how the car should look. And eventually, my cool 51 Chevy became her cool 51 Chevy. It was her idea to leave the rusty patina shell the way nature made it and stitch the interior colors to match the calico body. As the ride came together, she even named her newfound project, Betty. Well, one day Betty, being the star that she is, was cast in a scene for a TV show. The scene involved Mark McNary, the New York-based designer, stopping by the shop to borrow one of my cool rides. See, Mark actually had a meeting that day with Pharrell Williams at the Beverly Hills Hotel. When my designer buddy came to the shop, he naturally chose Betty to roll up into the meeting with. Well, that's where my journey really began. See, as my buddy Mark was dealing with Pharrell, I got a text from the production company that said, "Showed Pharrell your car. He loves it. He wants one." I texted back, "Tell him, for him, I'll cut him a discount. He cool." I really didn't know who Pharrell Williams was yet. He still hadn't come out with Happy and that big famous hat. I believe I could have been a bit more gracious. The next text I get says, "Pharrell wants to know if that car could be converted to electric." To that I wrote, "I can do one." And that, my brothers and sisters, is how the big spark for the eRod was born. Now, at this time in history, the Prius had been around for a while, and the Tesla just came on the scene with rave reviews. What is it I hear about all this big torque out of these electric motors? How much do they cost? Where can I get one? What's involved with building a cool electric car? What components do I need? Well, there was only one way to find out.
What's up, JD?
Corey,
what's
my up, electrical engineer buddy that actually works for an electric car slash truck company.
In bad shape.
He has the know-how, and he would know what parts I need and where I could get them. So I hit up my boy Corey for some much-needed info. First, I wanted to know, how much does an electric motor cost? What other components am I going to need to put together an electric hard rod? Corey let me know what parts I would need and approximately how much they would cost. After I found out how expensive this stuff was, especially about 10 grand for batteries alone, I left it at that and didn't think too much more about it.
Now this has a capacity that's much less than a single lead acid battery. However, it can output up to 20 times the rated capacity. So this battery can technically do 4,000 amps, up to 3,000 to 4,000 amps for a very short period of time.
Like a quarter mile.
Nice. Lead-acid battery can't do that, man.
After some time went by, I had already picked up another old rusty Chevy coupe to take the place of the car my wife took over. Now, as I was putting the pieces together, I get a text from my boy Corey. He says, "If you want to put together an electric car, now is the time. The company I work for is going under, and I think they'll sell you all the pieces you need from a car they already have together at the shop." I says, "Sounds cool to me." So basically, I took some savings, I struck a deal, and got what I needed for my eRod for about half price. The next step, Corey has to take me to the shop and extract the electric pieces I need from this already running car.
Dude, please tell me, what exactly are we getting for our money? I just want to know, I mean, Usually I'm getting a V8. I'm getting a tranny, I'm getting a V8. What exactly am I getting? I'm going down here. I don't know anything about these things. What am I getting, bro? Just tell me what I'm getting for my money.
All right, listen. You're getting an electric motor, a battery pack, a motor controller, and a charger. All right?
Hey, let me just say something, boy. I just want to spin wheels. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I want to make some wheels spin. I want to make some tires spin. I want to see some rubber burning. You think we're going to be able to do that with what we're getting? That's all my question is.
I know we can do that. We can definitely do that.
You know it.
Oh, yeah.
I like your style, bro.
Oh, yeah.
What? You got your buddy in there, he's gonna let us in?
Should.
So it's in a sports car, and y'all hardly ever ride this thing?
Never. Not in 5 years.
Really?
Been sitting here under a tarp, waiting for a special owner to come take on it.
Nice. I'll tell you what, that's a nice looking body, whatever's under that thing.
I think you'll be happy with it. Let's grab that corner.
All right. Let me take my shades off, man.
There you go.
I gotta see this thing. Wow.
All the way.
Wow.
Boom.
So everything we need is in there, huh?
That's right.
Madness, man. Straight madness.
Battery charger, controller, motor, brain. It's coming out. Most of this in here, it's coming out. It looks raggedy. We're gonna take it apart. We're gonna make it look good later.
That's what we came for. Boys and girls, you're right with us. This here thing, it's in this here thing right here, is going in a 49 Chevrolet. Have we done it before? No. Are we gonna be able to do it? I don't know, but I'm willing to try. Let's roll them big dice, what do you think?
Let's do it.
Let's go. Sweet.
Oh, let's bring it home now.